After waiting several hours, the time has come.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, we're going to go straight into this subject, and I'm going to say this. Some of you will disagree, and to those who disagree, that's okay. I don't ask everyone to agree with what I'm saying, but what I'm going to talk about, I'm going to back by Scripture. And if you disagree and you want to have a disagreement with me about it, show me in Scripture where it is different, or show me in Scripture where what I'm saying is contrary to what you believe. So with that being said, we're going to get into baptism. Now, the teaching is that we have to be baptized with water, either through immersion or sprinkling. Now, some also believe that there are a few exceptions to this. So already we're at a point of conditions. Some believe that you have to be baptized by water, but yet there are some exceptions. And basically what they're saying is that if your health prevents it, or if your situation doesn't allow for it, that you don't have to be baptized by immersion or sprinkling. And an example of each would be, say, someone with a serious medical condition, or an individual who's incarcerated. They probably can't be baptized. So what you're doing by saying that they're excluded as an exception is you're making a justification, because if we didn't make that justification, what we would be saying is that we all have to be baptized, and if you can't, oh well, you're condemned. And who wants to condemn someone who can't, based on a situation or even a medical condition? So already part of some people's belief is that they're excluded. It's okay for them. Now, to say this is to say that the Father makes exceptions like that. And why would the Father institute something as necessary as baptism by immersion or sprinkling, and then make exceptions? Look, Hebrews 13:8 says that he is the same always, today, yesterday, and forever. And Malachi 3:6 even goes on to say that he is the Lord and he changes not. So whatever he says is, he makes no exceptions. We're either on this side or that side, no exceptions. So this is already contrary to what the Word says. He doesn't make exceptions. So there's something flawed in that philosophy that everyone has to be baptized, but there are exceptions. I can't buy into that, and you shouldn't either. So we're going to move on. You have to remember that we are justified by faith, and to be justified means to be proven right or just, free of blame, absolved, or qualified. So we're qualified by our faith. Now, the question about whether baptism is necessary or not, I say that it is, but, and I know, but changes everything, and I want it to change everything, because I believe, according to Scripture, that it's not necessary by water. We have to remember that baptism is a ceremony. John the Baptist baptized people in that ceremony. It was a symbolic ceremony. Now, was it to go on forever? We're going to find out according to what Scripture says. Now, I'm sure everyone remembers the thief on the cross, who's been the subject of many a discussion. Remember that he was promised by the Savior that he was assured of a place in paradise. Now, the question immediately gets to be was, how did he receive the promise of a place in paradise? There's nothing to say that he was baptized. He was a thief being crucified. So how was he given a place in paradise without being baptized? Now the answer to the question is, he was baptized. But we have to understand how he was baptized. He wasn't baptized through water. He was baptized through the word, by the word. Now look, let's go back to Romans 5:1, and it reads, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, does a thief on the cross not fall into that category? He was justified by his faith. He believed, and through that belief, he was baptized. He was baptized by the word. Now, to baptize, you have to understand, means simply to cleanse or purify or initiate. That's all it is. Now, John was doing it through water. The Savior just baptized a thief through his word. Remember, everything goes through him. Now let's look at John the Baptist for a second. Now, in John 1:26, he says, I baptize with water. He said he wasn't a Christ or a prophet. He was simply a voice of one crying in the wilderness. He said he baptized with water. Now, he said that he was sent to baptize with water, but there was one coming mightier than he that would baptize with what? With the Holy Spirit. So already, it should be relatively clear that John is saying, look, I'm doing this with water, but there's someone coming after me who is mightier, who's going to baptize with the Holy Spirit. See, the Savior didn't use water. He didn't need water. He is all that. He used the Holy Spirit. Now, go with me to Matthew 28:19. Matthew 28:19 reads, it says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. See, our Savior told his disciples to go forth and teach the world, baptizing them. He didn't say baptizing them in water. He said baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. See, even after John the Baptist, the Savior sent forth his own disciples to baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. He didn't even say anything about water. He told them how to baptize. He told them how to initiate individuals. Like I said, baptism is a ceremony. It was symbolic. John started it. By all accounts, John started it. That's how he was baptizing folks. And then came one mightier than him. If you look at it, it changed from that point forward, from John to when the Savior came and he baptized him. It changed. It became a spiritual baptism. The symbolic baptism of water need not be done anymore. Now, we're going to keep going. In Acts 2:41, we're told that they who gladly received his word were baptized. All they had to do was receive his word. Through what? Through their belief, through faith. If you receive his word through your belief, through faith, you are baptized. It says nothing about water. Water baptism apparently is done away with. You need to study scripture to see these things so we can end these arguments over needing to do and not do certain things. All these ceremonial things and stuff apparently are all done away with. We are doing things spiritually, but people aren't teaching that. Look, people are still being taught that we have to do things, do this, do that. It has changed to being about our faith and our belief in the Savior himself. Look, water does not baptize us. We're baptized through what? Through the Spirit. The ceremony of baptism is just that, a symbolic ceremony. We're baptized by faith through the Holy Spirit. Look, Peter was very clear and simple in what he said in Acts 2:38. Go with me to Acts 2:38. It reads, it says, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. It was simple as that. He said, repent and receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Be baptized. He didn't say anything about water. We're being baptized through the Holy Spirit. Now, if we go back to John 1:32, we'll see something else here. It says, "And John bare record, saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it abode upon him." Now, remember when John the Baptist saw the Savior coming, that's how John recognized him, because when the Spirit appeared unto John as a dove, it came upon the Savior. So John knew who he was. He was told that's how he would recognize him. Now, this Spirit, what was the Spirit that John saw? Okay, it was the Spirit of the Lord. It was the Holy Spirit. If you look at Isaiah 11:2, it says, "This was the Spirit of the Lord," or the Holy Spirit. Now, John tells us that the Savior would baptize us, like I said before, with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Luke 3:16 tells us, "and with fire." Now, in Luke 3:16, John tells us that the Savior will baptize us with what? The Holy Spirit and with fire. Now, what is fire? Fire is that desire or that thirst. See, we'll be baptized and then we'll have that fire and that thirst to want to learn, to want to teach, to want to do. But still, this is all predicated on faith and believing. See, we have to have that faith and belief to be baptized. If you don't have it, you're not going to be baptized. See, there are people running around today that didn't have that Spirit upon them because they don't believe. So, like the disciples in the upper room in Acts 2:3, let me read. It says, "And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as fire, and it set upon each of them." See, it came upon each, that tongue of fire came upon each of the disciples, and they were endowed with the Holy Spirit, with that fire, with that desire, and they went out and did what they were supposed to do. See, that's what we're all supposed to do. We're all supposed to be teaching. We're all supposed to be spreading the word and bringing others to the Savior. Now, we have to know what the Holy Spirit is and what the Holy Spirit does. So, let's look at Isaiah 11:2. It reads, it says, "And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord." Or what's that? Obedience. This is what the Holy Spirit is. The Holy Spirit teaches all things to us. It taught the Savior and it will teach us, but it has to be upon us. Faith, belief. Now, the Holy Spirit, like I said, teaches us all things, and everyone is not walking around with the Holy Spirit upon them because, like I said, they don't believe, so they're not going to have it. So, who can be baptized by the Spirit? Go with me to 1 Corinthians 12:13. 1 Corinthians 12:13 reads, it says, "For by one Spirit are we all baptized into the body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one Spirit." Now, listen to what it said. It didn't say this group or that group. It says Jews or Gentiles. So it said his chosen people, who were the Jews back then, or anyone. All, it says, all can be baptized by the Spirit. And if we look at verse 14, it says, "For the body is not one member, but many." So everyone can be included. It's a matter of choice. Okay, so in closing, we're going to start here. Let's go to John 3:18. It reads, it says, "For he that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he have not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." It's simple as that. Look, we are saved by hope. And hope that is not seen is what? It's not hope. It is faith. And we have to walk by faith, not by sight. Look, we have to walk by faith because why? Faith is the substance or a confidence of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So we have to walk by faith. We have to believe. We can't hope to see everything that we want to believe in. We have to blindly believe. That's why sometimes it's called blind faith. And that can be a beautiful thing because it really tests you. It really puts you to the fire to walk in that. Go with me to 2 Corinthians 4:18. 2 Corinthians 4:18. It says, while we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, or they're just temporary. But the things which are not seen are eternal. See, we can't see those eternal things yet. But so many people are focused on these temporal things. This is what's going to condemn them. Yeah, they won't believe because they're condemning themselves to these temporal things. We have to put our faith in these things that we can't see. But we are being told in the Word that these things are eternal and they are ours. If we just believe, if we just have faith, we have to live in that hope. And understand, faith is belief. We have to believe and trust Him in His Word and on those things that we don't yet see. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2Bay7. I'm out.